in this video. Allshot devices split the opinions of factory riders. Ole Espargaro puts a price on his Repsol Honda seat. And Aleix Espargaro believes Honda and Ducati have been sandbagging. My name is Sankalp and this is your Racing News Fix. Ducati have always been on the forefront of the technical innovation in MotoGP, and their ride height devices, which they first introduced in 2018, are causing a lot of stir in the paddock at the moment. Back in 2018, it was a simple device in the rear of the Ducati used at the start of the race to minimize wheelie off the line. But this year's Ducati Evolution is a repeatable ride height device controller at both the front and the rear, which means the rider has to constantly engage and disengage it multiple times a lap, lap after lap. This has reignited the discussion of safety versus performance, and it seems like the grid is split on whether it is a good thing or a bad thing. The performance gain is very clear. Race starts are fabulous, and getting out of the corners, the bikes can get to top speeds faster and safer. But the other side of the argument is that higher than ever speeds are rendering all the circuits unsafe due to limited runoff areas. Moreover, they add multiple additional tasks for the riders on every lap, and we are just one malfunction away from a very big accident. Speaking about the whole shot devices, Yamaha's Fabio Quartararo said, "For me, it is starting to get too much. In 2019, the starting procedure was just that you arrive in neutral, press the launch control and go. Now you need to check too many things. At the end, you get more performance, but it is starting to be too much." Agreeing with Quartararo, Suzuki's Joan Mir said, "I am with Fabio. For me also, it is starting to be too much. Every time we arrive faster into the straight, we will soon reach 370 km/h. The layouts are the same, and for sure it is more performance. If you use everything, then it is more performance, but it is not the best thing for safety." Honda's Marc Marquez has been very clear since the beginning that the whole shot devices don't add much to the competition. Voicing his concerns, Marc said, "For me, it is something that for the future they must remove. I already said last year when I arrived after my injury. For the show, we don't gain anything. Okay, it is prototype bikes, but for the street bikes, you don't need the whole shot device. At all the tracks, they are trying to increase the runoff areas. You are arriving faster on the breakpoints and braking later. So for the future, it makes no sense." As expected, Ducati's Pecco Bagnaia did not say anything negative about it and simply brushed off the topic by saying, "For me, I just have to press the button, so it is not a problem." Aprilia's Maverick Vinales agrees with Quartararo and Mir that it is in fact starting to get a bit too much, but also pointed out the safety benefits. Vinales said, "It is going too far and there are too many things to do. But at least the rear for the start and with the acceleration, I think it is safer." KTM's Brad Binder had no strong opinion on the matter and feels that we should just accept it and make the most out of it. Brad Binder said, "Sure, when you arrive at the grid, you have a lot more to do. But the reality is that it is here to stay, and I think every manufacturer needs to make the best of it." With the new Honda bike being much more suitable for his riding style, Ole Espargaro wants to fight for the title this year. And he might have to do just that if he wants to keep his seat for 2023 and maybe beyond. Marc Marquez, although still 29, is now one of the older riders on the grid, and it is only natural that Repsol Honda want to put a young rider alongside him to be their next title fighter. Over the winter, there were plenty of rumors suggesting Repsol Honda going behind Fabio Quartararo and Joan Mir, and now some even believe that we might see Pedro Acosta alongside Marc Marquez in 2023. All this means one thing and one thing only. Ole Espargaro might be losing his precious Repsol Honda seat, but Ole is determined to prove that he deserves to stay for a little longer and fight at the top for wins and titles. Ole said, "I'm not worried about anything. I would worry if the tests had gone wrong and I knew that things are not going to go well during the season. But seeing how everything is going, the renewal is what worries me the least of all. Whoever wants my bike will have to be in front of me." And starting his 18th season, Aprilia's Aleix Espargaro believes that both Ducati and Honda were sandbagging in the pre-season test, and we are yet to see their full potential. In the pre-event media debrief in Qatar, speaking about other manufacturers, Aleix Espargaro said, "I had the feeling that neither Honda or Ducati have fully shown their cards. There have been only two test circuits, and I think Honda has improved a lot, and they also have four very strong riders on the track. There are also many strong Ducatis, and we will see what they are really capable of." If you made it till here, help me out. Subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell. Here are two more videos which you might enjoy. My name is Sankalp, and I'll be back with another video very soon.